Physics constantly tells us weird and wonderful things about the world around us, but sometimes it comes up with ideas that are downright scary. So here are three terrifying physics ideas to keep you up at night. Hello there, my name's Barth, and normally I really like physics. Every so often though, I come across an idea that hits me right in the existential dread. So I thought I'd share some of those ideas with you today. If you enjoyed this video or really hate it, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. Let's get into it. The first physics idea I find scary is known as the heat death of the universe. I know, already sounds scary, right? But it's not about the end of the universe in fire and brimstone like the name suggests. Actually, it's somewhat the opposite. Physicists have this concept called entropy that they like to talk about. If we're studying a system, like a bunch of particles, or a car traveling along a road, or anything we'd want to study in physics, then we can use the concept of entropy to essentially measure how much disorder there is in our system. In reality, there's a bit more nuance to this idea, but essentially, a well-ordered and arranged system is said to have low entropy, and a disordered system is said to have high entropy. For example, if we have three colored balls, all sitting on the floor, then we can think of this as an ordered system. All the balls are in the same place, next to each other, and there's just a few ways to arrange these balls all next to each other on the floor. Now, this system is said to have low entropy. There's only a few ways of arranging it. By contrast, let's look at a less ordered or more disordered system. Now, if the balls could go anywhere on the floor, a chair, or a table, then there are loads of different ways to arrange them. And this is why our system is said to have a higher entropy than the other one, because we can arrange it in many more different ways. Now, there's a really important law of physics that tells us that as time passes, the total amount of entropy that exists in a closed system either stays the same or it increases. In other words, as time passes, things get more and more disordered, or they stay at the same level of disorder. Now, that's not to say that we can't make things more ordered in places. We know intuitively that we can make things more ordered by tidying stuff away, for example. But this law of physics says that this decrease in entropy has to be balanced by an increase in entropy elsewhere that is just as big or even bigger. For example, by tidying stuff away to make it neater, we've spent energy that gets wasted as heat, which increases the entropy of the air around us, and therefore the rest of the universe. Lesson learned, don't tidy anything away, because you're making the universe messier as a result, on the whole. But why is this idea scary in the first place? Well, if everything has to get more and more disordered over time, then eventually nice ordered systems, like stars, planets, animals, and humans, may not be able to exist at all. In our universe, life as we know it can exist because the universe is currently not in what's known as thermal equilibrium. The distribution of energy is different in different places, and so we can take energy from one region and expend it somewhere else to live or to move or to exist. But once the energy gets totally evenly distributed, this won't be possible. This concept is known as the heat death of the universe because of the idea that when we do things, some energy is wasted as heat. And heat is an essentially random dissipation of energy that increases disorder. Now remember, this doesn't mean that order can't increase in some places and at some times. It's just that overall, as time passes, you would expect the disorder to either stay the same or increase. It's also worth noting that there may be ways for the universe not to end in a heat death, but that would depend on the structure of the universe that we still don't understand well enough yet. I'll leave some resources in the description if you'd like to learn more about how our universe may avoid this bland and homogeneous fate and continue allowing life as we know it to exist. For now though, let's look at our second terrifying idea. It's to do with the expansion of the universe. It turns out that space itself is expanding, and it seems to be happening everywhere that we can observe, all over the universe. What this means is that galaxies that are far away from us are moving away from us really, really quickly because of the expansion of space between us and them. In fact, everything in the universe is moving away from everything else in the universe. And the further that two objects are from each other, the faster they are moving away from each other because there's more space between them to do the expanding. Some very distant objects are moving away from each other faster than the speed of light. Now, you might say, but I thought the speed of light was the speed limit of the universe. Nothing can go faster than that, right? Well, yes, that's true, but the speed of light is the maximum speed at which objects can move through space. In this case, it's actually space itself that's expanding. Again, more slowly than the speed of light at each point in space, but because it's happening everywhere, the cumulative effect for faraway objects is that they appear to be moving apart faster than the speed of light. This means that if two galaxies can send signals to each other right now, that may not be the case in the future. If they get far enough that they recede from each other faster than the speed of light, then from that point on, light won't be able to get from one to another. In other words, objects that aren't bound to each other by gravity will eventually separate from each other so quickly that not even light will be able to travel between them. Will become lonelier and lonelier in an ever-growing universe, unable to communicate with other celestial bodies and potentially life forms that exist in their own little bubble of darkness. Luckily, however, the universe may not expand forever like this. Again, it depends on the structure of our universe that we don't quite have the tools to be able to measure just yet. Anyway, let's move on quickly to our third terrifying idea. For this one, I have a full video that I'll be making about it, so subscribe if you want to see that. The idea is that we could be inside the event horizon of a black hole that hasn't even formed yet, and we would have no way of knowing until it was too late. A black hole is an object that's extremely dense and has a ridiculously strong gravitational field, and its event horizon is the boundary beyond which nothing can escape, not even light. Now, this isn't unique to us. Any place of the universe could be inside the event horizon of a yet-to-form black hole, and they'd only know once it was too late to escape. The basic idea is that we can imagine a bunch of photons of light, all moving in a sphere towards the center, getting smaller and smaller. Using the general theory of relativity, physicists have shown that eventually, this perfect sphere of infalling photons would in fact form a black hole. The event horizon would actually start out infinitesimally small and then very quickly grow outwards as the light photons fall inwards. This would happen until the event horizon gets to the same size as the infalling photons. Once the photons cross the event horizon, the horizon will not continue to grow and the black hole will be fully formed. The trouble is, something in this region of space here has no way of knowing that they're about to be in deep trouble, because the event horizon growing on one side of them grows super quickly and can't be seen anyway, and they won't see the photons until the photons cross their path. At which point, they'll be inside the event horizon, or at least at the boundary. Bit scary, right? Luckily, it's highly unlikely that a perfectly spherical arrangement of photons, or other matter, would exist, and they would all be moving perfectly towards their shared spherical center. So let's not spend too much time worrying about how we could find ourselves in the danger zone of a black hole with no way out. Those were my three terrifying ideas. Did you find them terrifying as well? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. If you were disturbed by the video, then I'm really sorry. I thought I'd experiment a bit with the content on this channel. So let me know what you think of this kind of stuff. Bit less mathy and rigorous, but a bit more conceptual and scary, I think. I'd also like to say a huge thanks to my Giga patrons and all the others over on my Patreon page. I'll leave a link to that in the description if you'd like to support me on there. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very soon.